Yo, I spend way too much time on Instagram, probably more than I should, and the reason I spend a lot of time on that is because I see a lot of images which make me go, oh cool, or make me excited about seeing a new place or doing a new thing or exploring. A lot of the things on my Instagram feed are kayaking. Like probably 70 to 90% of my Instagram is whitewater kayaking, expeditions, people who are doing new freestyle stuff, some new like big drop stuff, people in Canada, people all over the world. Really love seeing it. It's awesome. Something I get asked pretty often is how to take better photos for Instagram, even if you don't have a really expensive camera. And something I tell people pretty often is that you don't need a sick camera to take good photos. Like you probably have a sick camera in your pocket right now. It's not really about what camera you're using, it's just about how you're using it. So what I wanted to do this week is give you a rundown on a few tips to take better kayaking photos just with the camera that you already have. So I wanted to run you through three or four really useful tips for taking better kayaking photos just with the camera that you already have. So step one to taking better kayaking photos is, maybe it's gonna sound obvious, but you've got to get out of your kayak. Like if you're still in your kayak, you're gonna have a very limited point of view, which sometimes is gonna be cool, but most of the time it's not gonna be cool. You're gonna be too far away. You're not gonna have real perspective on the photo you're trying to take and what the rapid's looking like, what the kayak is feeling like. You won't be able to convey the same set of emotions that you can by literally just going to the side, climbing out of your kayak, and finding a better spot to take that photo. There's a bunch of different places that would constitute a better spot to take a photo. Higher up, so you have a looking down angle. Lower down, so you're looking up from the side, from behind, in front, so the kayaker's coming towards you. Where the kayaker really close to you, where the kayaker really far away from you, so you're showing more like that landscape and giving more perspective about where you actually are. That might be cool. That might be somewhere that's like in a real urban scene and downtown. You might have big buildings in the background. It might be somewhere in more of a nature scene and it's maybe surrounded by something cool nature, or maybe it's like seasonally the surroundings are really pretty because it's like September, October and the leaves are changing color and that's sick too. Moving around, moving your feet, getting out of your boat and walking around a bit. And this is also another great time where you can just have your throw bag with you, and if someone's in trouble, like you're there to take a sweet photo, but you can also help them with safety too, so that you might not have expected that they need your help, and now you're like, boom, camera down, throw bag away. Look at that, you're a hero. Okay, so once you've got into a different place, you've taken a few photos, you're pretty happy with it, don't stop there. Okay, before you just hit it to Instagram, there's a couple of things you can do to make your photos look a lot better. Just right here on your phone. There's some really good free apps. One I like to use on my phone photos a lot is called Snapseed. It's free. They're not paying me to make this video. I like the app and I'm gonna tell you about it. So let's just take it all here. Take a quick deep dive in. So I'm opening my phone, I'm on Snapseed. It's a really easy to use photo editing app. And the reason I like it is because you can get a bunch of kind of quick edits. Like right in the bottom here, it's got a bunch of these like pre-programmed looks, which you can just bash out and make stuff look way better, which is sick. But the other reason I like it is because it has a tune image function with like kind of ups and down sliders. And this works really similar to a program called Adobe Lightroom, which is the main photo editing software that I use, and that has a lot of tools and features for editing photos and kind of helping them look their best. But a lot of those features are here for free on this app, Snapseed, and it's on your phone, it's super convenient. You can just be out on the river one day, snap a cool pic, and actually make it look really, really good right out of the gate. And I know you are thinking like, yeah, whatever, you're lying, Seth, there's no way. I'm gonna cycle through the screen now. Here's a bunch of photos I took with my phone. They look totally fine, you know, like some of them even look good. And they just got to be that way because it's not really about the camera that you have or like what camera phone you have, or like if you have a really expensive camera, if you don't. The most important part of taking better photos is that 3 inches right behind the camera here. It's like right here, being able to see what you're taking a photo of and trying to tell a story with that photo. And there's lots of different stories you can tell in whitewater kayaking, and that's kind of what makes taking photos of it like exciting and rewarding. And if you're not sure how to tell that story, there's some really good information on like how to frame photos and like photography tutorials out there, like on YouTube, on other platforms that I highly recommend checking out. Maybe in the future, maybe I'll get a more kayak like specific one. And I just wanted to give you a few kind of ideas here for things you can do to improve your whitewater photography without spending a ton of money on cameras and lenses and all the other peripheral gear that gets into that. Like, you can start right now.